Want help to grow your business? Download Brin, the world's first business advisor in your pocket. To find out more, visit brin.ai or search the App Store today.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Google Made Easy. My name is Peter Moriarty. I'm your host and I look forward to sharing the content that we have ready for you in this episode. So this episode, we're going to be covering how to set up and successfully use Google Hangouts. We're going to be showing you right from the very basics up until you are expert level on using Google Hangouts in your business. So let's take a quick look at what we're going to be covering. But before that, let's go through two quick ground rules. Number one is, first up, if you're following along at home, we are going to get super practical in this session. So if you've got your computer there, make sure it's out and ready and connected to the internet so you can get started and follow along with what we're doing. Or you can just take some notes if you'd like to write it down and implement later on. And number two, make sure you're connecting with us and the rest of the Business Blueprint community on social media. So use the hashtag Google Made Easy and hashtag Business Blueprint, and we can keep the conversation going. So I'm definitely on Twitter and Facebook, so make sure you check in by going to businessblueprint.com/experts, and you can check out all of my social profiles there. So what are we going to be covering in this episode? We are talking about Google Hangouts and how you can get it set up for your business. So to start us off, we're going to be talking about a basic overview of Google Hangouts, how you can get started in your business. So it would be a good idea if you're already on Google Apps to get set up on Hangouts then, but you can also use Hangouts if you've just got a personal Gmail account as well. So we're going to show you how you can do that. Next up, we'll be covering how to actually set up Google Hangouts within your browser, on your computer, and also on your mobile device as well. Next up, how to see who's online and start chatting to people. We're going to show you how to use the app, how to use the Google Hangouts app to actually connect with your colleagues. Then next up, how to find someone else and start a conversation. So how do we actually connect with someone, start that conversation? Next up, how to start a group chat and then add people, or you can even leave the group chat as well. We'll show you how to do that and how you can use group chats to help manage the informal communication in your business. Next, how to use search so you can view a complete history of all of your chats in Google Hangouts. Next up, how to start a video hangout and run your meetings. We're even going to do a video hangout with the team here. We're going to hang out one of our friends and say hello to them online. And then how to actually use the built-in tools to manage notifications. So we don't want to be pinged all the time by notifications. We're going to use Google Hangouts, tweak some of the tools that we have there so you can customize it just to the right amount of notifications that you need. Next, we'll cover how to help someone else get started with Hangouts. So if you want to start a Hangout with somebody who's new to Hangouts, we'll help you out getting started with them. And finally, how you can use Hangouts to set up a boardroom ready for Google Hangouts. So we'll show you the hardware that you need and exactly what you need to do to set up your boardroom to run Google Hangouts with. So let's get started. I'm super excited to get into this with you. So we're talking about Google Hangouts. Let's do a quick overview of Google Hangouts. So Google Hangouts is Google's answer to Skype, where, you know, in the Microsoft world and the rest of the world have used Skype. It's had tremendous success, just like Dropbox, in the consumer market with connecting people. Now, Google have built Hangouts to be a part of their Google Apps for Work business ecosystem. And what that means is everybody who's got a Google Apps for Work account has access to Hangouts. Now, if you've got a Gmail account, you can also access Hangouts as well. So anyone with an Android device or a Gmail account can also get access to Google Hangouts. There's two main parts to Google Hangouts. Number one is Google Hangouts is a video chat platform. The great thing about it is there's no software to install. It all runs 100% in the browser, just like Google Docs and Gmail. You don't have to install software and upgrade it and worry about versions and all that kind of thing and call the IT guy when it breaks. It just works because it's available in the browser all the time. Number two, the best thing about Google Hangouts is it is also an instant messaging client as well. So what that means is you can actually use Google Hangouts for informal communication between you and your team members. Now, this is fantastic when a text message or maybe an email doesn't quite suffice. If you want to send quick informal messages between your colleagues and they're sitting in the same office as you, it's a bit weird to kind of type out a formal email. Dear Peter, who's sitting next to me, kind regards, would you like to go for lunch this afternoon? How about 2 p.m.? Kind regards, Peter. It's a kind of a bit weird to send that. So Google Hangouts is great for the informal communication. It's also great to keep rapidly in contact with offshore and remote staff as well. So if you're working from home, if you want to get a couple of hours work done from the beach or from a cafe, or maybe you've got a geographically distributed team or you're taking advantage of outsourcing, then you can use Google Hangouts to keep in touch with your team. It is super, super useful for that. So that's what we use Google Hangouts for. They're the best two features, and we're going to be diving right into how you can get started with Google Hangouts. So now we're going to talk about how to get set up with Google Hangouts in your browser. Now, the easiest way to get started with Google Hangouts is just simply by going to hangouts.google.com, and that's where you can get started signing into Hangouts. Now I'm going to show you how to add some plugins and some add-ons and some other bits and pieces, and it's important that you take notice of those and add those to Google Chrome as well. But the way to get started is to go straight to hangouts.google.com. So let's do a quick demo of that, and I'm going to show you how we can get started with Google Hangouts. So here we are in the browser. Let's sign into hangouts.google.com, and it's going to bring up our Hangouts page. Now, once I'm already signed in with my Google account, it's automatically going to bring up all of my conversations with different clients and all of my contacts that I'm connected to. But if you're not yet signed in or you haven't started with Hangouts, here's what Hangouts is going to look like in a new browser. So I'm going to open up this in my incognito tab in Hangouts. Here you go. It looks pretty much the same, but it's going to ask you to sign in. And when you sign in, you can create a new account with Gmail, which will allow you to get started if you haven't already started with a Gmail account. So once you're signed in, we now have Google Hangouts online in the browser, and we can use Google Hangouts to connect with any of our friends by either chatting or creating a video call. But what about other apps that you can use to integrate with Hangouts? We've got two apps that we really recommend you check out and use for Google Hangouts on your computer. So the way to get Google Apps Hangouts added to your Chrome browser is by visiting the Chrome Web Store. And we're going to show you just what that looks like. So we'll go ahead and go to the Chrome Web Store on Google. And once we search for this, here we go, we'll open up the Chrome Web Store. There's two different Google Hangouts apps that you want to pick up for Chrome. So I'm going to search for Hangouts here. And you'll notice here that there is a Hangouts app, and there is also a Hangouts extension. Now, there's a tiny difference between the two of these. An extension is something that sits in the menu bar of Google Chrome, and it gives you a button that you can click and bring it up at any time. An app is a Chrome app that is a standalone app. And what that means is it'll open in its own window. I like to have both, so I've installed both the Hangouts app and the Hangouts extension. Now make sure you're getting the apps and extensions that are actually provided and developed by Google so you know you're getting the right ones. So let's have a look here in my apps. You can see I've got the Google Hangouts app offered by google.com, so I know it's the right one. And then there's the Google Apps extension offered by google.com. Now, I've already got these installed. So when I click on it, it's going to give me an option to launch the app. But what you'll see on your screen, if I copy this and let's go over to our Chrome Web Store, you'll see a link to actually add the app right here where it's gray at the moment. So when you go to add the app and the extension, all you need to do is click the Add App button, and that will add it to your Google Chrome. So once we've got these actually added to our Chrome, how do we access the two different apps? I'm going to show you how to do that, first with the extension, and then we'll go to the Google app. So first up, if you have a look in my Chrome browser, you can see that up here I've got this little button next to my other extensions. So these give me additional functionality for adding extra to Chrome. Now, if you haven't already, make sure you check out our special episode on my top 15 Chrome extensions. And that's got a massive array of all of the best extensions to add to Chrome. So once we click our Hangouts extension here, on my desktop, you'll notice that my Hangouts window has opened and all of my Hangouts chats have opened up there. Now, if I want to open up an individual chat with one of my team members, I can just click onto the window and it's going to open that up in these little tabs. So that's the Hangouts extension, and that's a great way to make sure you're keeping in touch with your Hangouts conversations, even if you might not have the conversation window open on your screen. Now, next up is the Hangouts app. That was the extension. We're now going to have a look at the app. Now, Google Apps are accessed by going to the Apps menu in Google Chrome. So when I click the Apps button here in my menu bar, you'll see here that all of the different Google Apps that have been added to Chrome are available for me. Now, when I click the Google Hangouts app, you'll see here that this actually opens in a standalone window. I've got one special window dedicated to all of my Hangouts conversations. So you'll be able to see here conversations from independent colleagues, even chat conversations and group conversations as well. So that's the basics of getting the apps and extensions added to Google Chrome so you can get 100% set up in your browser. So remember, there's three ways to access Google Hangouts. Number one, through hangouts.google.com. Number two, through the extension that's just pops up above whatever other windows you have. And number three, by the dedicated Hangouts app, which gives you one full screen app just for all of your Hangout conversations. So next, let's talk about how we see who's online and how we start chatting to some of our colleagues. So you would have noticed that in my conversation window as it popped up, there were little dots that were either green or not green, and they show the status of our different participants and friends that we've got on Google Hangouts. Let's take another look and see what I mean. So as you can see here, next to Joyce, Chi, and Hardy, we've got a little green dot next to their profile. So you can see even Dale here, right next to their profile photos, you can see that that person is online and available. So what that means is if I send a message to that person, they're automatically going to get a pop-up notification on either their mobile device or their computer. Now, Google Hangouts is really smart. When you're working on your computer, you're actually going to get notifications that pop up on your computer, but your phone will stay silent. If your computer's closed and you're not working on your machine and you're signed out of Hangouts, if you've got Hangouts signed in on your phone, if you're out and about, you'll start getting notifications on your phone. So Google, in a way, knows where you are, which is pretty cool, but really it's just using whether or not you're signed in at the computer to determine where to send your notifications. It's really clever and it makes sure that you're not being notified for anything that's not important to you. Now, next up, Google will also synchronize the conversations between your mobile device and your computer as well. So that means no matter where you are, you've got the same chats and the same conversations. So how do we get started chatting to people? Let's start our first conversation with one of our colleagues. So I want to have a quick hangout with my colleague Jen from Blueprint. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start typing Jen's email here. So let's put in Jen, and you can see that Jen's actually popped up here. And Jen hasn't been connected with me just yet. So what we're gonna need to do is send Jen an invitation to chat. So I'm gonna go ahead and send that invitation, and it might take a couple of minutes, so we'll leave that with Jen and we'll wait for Jen to come online. Now, you can see here with some of my other colleagues, I've got conversations back and forward. Let's click on my conversation with Andrew here, and I can see back and forward the chats between myself and Andrew. Now, one of the cool things is, as you can see, on the Hangouts notifications, down the bottom of the chat, I can see a semi-transparent picture of Andrew there. And what that means is Andrew has read up to that point in the conversation. I can see exactly what messages.
To continue enjoying this presentation, download Brin, the world's first business advisor in your pocket. To find out more, visit brin.ai or search the App Store today.